Hi, this is Michael McCarthy. We're going to take a look here at some of the Ornatrix version 3 new features. This is a little sneak peek of the symmetry modifier changes that we're making. And you can see we have this beautiful fitness model that has been provided graciously by TurboSquid. And with the model, actually, the splines for the hair and the athletic hairdo kind of comes with it, which is good. So we've just added a guides from spline and then an ability to ground those splines to the scalp itself. Now we may want to add our symmetry from here, so I'm just going to kind of zoom in and add an OX symmetry modifier. Now this is not a new modifier, but we've added a couple of things that have been highly requested. First, you can kind of see down the middle here that we have some overlap of some of the things that have been mirrored to the other side. So we've added this nice feature, use ignore distance. And what happens with that is it's going to kind of cull away some of those splines that you might need, and you can, you know, adjust that so that you get a more smooth seam down the middle of your character. Now we can go in right below symmetry and choose our OX edit guides. We'll turn on show end result and go in to start brushing this hair. And we can brush this hair, and of course that's going to happen on both sides of the character. We'll see that coming over to the other side, which is very nice. So we can kind of have that there. Now if we want to, after this, we can add in edit guides to get some asymmetry from our character. When we do that, we might want to use this other new feature, which is ground mirrored strands. So if we choose ground mirrored strands here, it's going to prevent us from having to add another ground strands modifier when we know that they're already grounded, and if we're mirroring them, then they should be grounded to the same object. So that kind of saves us a step there. And then when we go to OX edit guides to add a little asymmetry to this character, we can go into our brush tool and we can add a little asymmetry to, let's say, the ponytail here or something like that. So you can use any of your brush tools there and maybe kind of muss up the hair like so. So those are a few options that we added to our strand symmetry modifier in order to kind of improve user workflow. And hopefully you'll like those in our next release of Ornatrix version 3. Thank you very much.